مساء الخير عليكم جميعا، يا رب تكونوا كلكم بخير. النهارده احنا هنحل مع بعض الشيت بتاع المالتي كولينياريتي. لو في اي حاجه انا همشي يعني هحل معاكم كل الاسئله، لو في اي حاجه مش واضحه تقدروا ان انتم تبعتوا لي على الايميل. لو الاجابه بتاعه السؤال بسيطه اقدر ان انا ارد عليها من خلال الايميل هرد عليها، ولو محتاجه شرح ممكن ان انا في الفيديوز اللي بعد كده ان انا اوضحها بشكل اكبر. طيب نبتدي مع question 1 part 1 الاول. question 1 and 2 and false. In the simple regression model, multicollinearity refers to exact linear relationships between the regressors. طبعا this is false. ليه؟ Because multicollinearity arises when there is a multiple regression, not a simple regression. Multicollinearity, the problem بتظهر عندي لما يبقى فيه linear relationship between the regressors, يعني عندي more than one regressor أو more than one explanatory variable or more than one x، وبالتالي المشكلة دي عندي بتظهر. لكن وده بيظهر زي ما قلنا في المالتيبل ريجريشن، لكن في السيمبل ريجريشن مش هتظهر. ليه؟ Because I have only one regressor or one explanatory variable. Question 2. If multicollinearity is perfect, the regression coefficients are determinant and their standard errors are zero. طبعا as we have known قبل كده زي ما اتكلمنا في sheet 2 ان لما بيبقى عندي perfect multicollinearity this means that the matrix اللي هي x prime x is not in full rank and therefore I cannot calculate the inverse of x prime x. انا عندي البيتا هات هي ال x prime x inverse x prime y. If I have perfect multicollinearity then I cannot calculate the first part x prime x inverse and therefore the regression coefficients are not determinant, they are indeterminate. يعني I cannot calculate them. Well, standard errors are infinite. Why are the standard errors infinite? لو بصينا عندي المفروض لما بيبقى عندي perfect multicollinearity this is the shape of the variance. بيظهر عندي term في الdenominator اللي هو 1 minus r 2 3 squared. ال R 2 3 squared ده اللي هو ال correlation coefficient. This is the coefficient that measures the correlation between the explanatory variable 2 أو X2 and X3. وبالتالي لو أنا عندي perfect multicollinearity this means that R 2 3 squared will be equal to 1. يعني there is a perfect linear relationship between them. Therefore sigma squared will be divided by 0. يبقى it is infinite. The variance is infinite. Well, standard error, زي ما قلنا, it is the square root of the variance. وبالتالي also the standard error is infinite. طيب, question 3. If z equals x squared, so there will be a multicollinearity if we use z and x as regressors. زي ما قلنا قبل كده, this will be false. I won't have a multicollinearity problem. Why? Because the relationship between z and x in this case is non-linear. If z equal x, يعني لو عندي z equal x, يبقى كده أنا عندي linear relationship. But as long as x is raised to the power 2, or I have x squared, يبقى I'm talking about non-linear relationship between z and x, which means that there is no problem of multicollinearity. Number 4. Despite perfect multicollinearity, the OLS estimators are blue. برضو this statement is false. زي ما قلنا, perfect multicollinearity, this means that I cannot estimate the parameters. I have the regression coefficients are indeterminate, where standard errors are infinite. However, لو عندي imperfect multicollinearity, يعني ما فيش perfect linear relationship between the explanatory variables, يعني ال correlation coefficient ما بينهم is less than 1 but very close to it, يبقى ال OLS estimators بتوعي will be blue but with large variance. Large variance, this is the major problem that multicollinearity causes. يعني المشكلة الكبيرة اللي بتظهر عندي بسبب ال multicollinearity هي ان انا بيبقى عندي large variances which affects later on, تخلي عندي wider confidence intervals, تخلي عندي insignificant t-ratios, تخلي عندي high r-squared few insignificant or few significant parameters, هي اللي بتخلق عندي المشاكل دي كلها. لكن ايه المين امباكت او المين امبليكيشن بتاع الامبيرفكت مالتي كولينياريتي؟ اننا the OLS estimators are still blue, however they have large variances which affects somehow my estimates. زي ما احنا قلنا كده ان هي بتخلي في wider confidence interval, فبتخلي ان انا البيتا هاتس اللي انا بجيبها ما بتبقاش precise قوي. Number five, the only effect of multicollinearity is to make it hard to get coefficient estimates with small standard error. زي ما قلت, this answer is true. ليه؟ لأن الـ effect of multicollinearity, قلنا الـ main effect بتاعها هو أن بيبقى فيه large variances. وبالتالي بقى عندي large variance, اوكي, هو ده اللي بيعمل لي المشكله. So this is the main problem. بسبب اللارج فارينس ده بيبقى عندي wider confidence intervals والinsignificant ratios والhigh R squared. كل ده بينتج من الimplication الرئيسي او المين implication, which is there is large variances. Number six, having a small number of observation leads to estimators with small standard error. يعني لو عندي small n, sample size بتاعتي is small, ده هيخلي عندي ال estimators with small standard error it is false. ليه؟ لأن لما بيبقى عندي small n أو small number of observations, this means that I have the problem of micronumerosity أو near micronumerosity, as long as I am able to calculate or to estimate my coefficients. أنا زي ما احنا عارفين أنا عندي two types of micronumerosity. يعني small sample size ممكن تبقى exact micronumerosity أو near micronumerosity. لو exact micronumerosity, it gives me the same impact of perfect multicollinearity, which means if I have exact micronumerosity, then I cannot estimate the parameter. يبقى لو عندي exact micronumerosity هو ليها نفس التأثير بتاع perfect multicollinearity, يعني I cannot estimate beta hat. In case ان انا عندي near micronumerosity, دي بتبقى counterpart بتاعت imperfect multicollinearity او بتبقى الشبيهة بتاعت imperfect multicollinearity, and in that case I can estimate the parameters. However, بيبقى عندي المشكلة الرئيسية بتاعة الـ imperfect multicollinearity إن أنا بيبقى عندي large variances. يبقى if the sample size is small, هلاقي إن الـ variability عندي في الـ denominator, الـ variability عندي في الـ sample بتاعتي between the xi and x bar اللي هو الـ denominator بتاع الـ variance beta 2 hat زي ما أنا موضح لكم فيه الـ answers, becomes small. Since it is gets smaller, عندي small sample size, معناها ان عندي low variability in the axis, معناها ان the denominator of variance b2 hat will be small, and this will lead that the variance will increase. لما denominator يقل, ده معناها ان the variance will increase, لان في negative relationship ما بينه. يبقى to sum up thing, لما بيبقى عندي small number of observations, ده معناها إن أنا عندي lower variability in my explanatory variables, معناها إن الـ denominator بتاع الـ variance beta 2 hat will be small, which will lead that variance beta 2 hat will be large. يبقى ليها it has the same impact of imperfect multicollinearity. Number 7, multicollinearity. Small number of observations and small variance of the independent variables are all the same problem. زي ما قلنا it's true. لأن لو عندي imperfect multicollinearity, لو عندي small number of observations أو small variance زي ما قلنا ما بين ال xi وال x bar summation بتاعتهم اللي هي بتبقى عندي في ال denominator بتاع variance beta 2 hat, كل دول هيخلوا عندي the same problem أو will have the same main implication, which is إن أنا عندي إيه؟ which is إن أنا عندي large variances، وهو ده اللي بيخلق عندي كل المشاكل اللي بتظهر بعد كده في الimperfect multicollinearity. Number 8, micronumerosity is the counterpart of multicollinearity. Okay. It is true. زي ما قلنا micronumerosity refers to the small sample size. طالما عندي small sample size it will have the same impact of imperfect multicollinearity إن هي it will allow or it will lead to having large variances. اللي هي the same impact of imperfect multicollinearity. أنا هنا بتكلم على near micronumerosity وبتكلم على imperfect multicollinearity. يبقى الاثنين هيبقى ليهم نفس التأثير إن أنا هيبقى عندي large variances وبالتالي هيؤدوا لي المشاكل اللي هتظهر بعد كده. Number 9, exact micronumerosity arises when n, the sample size, is infinity. It is false. لأن the exact micronumerosity arises because of having small sample size. في the exact micronumerosity, أنا قلت عندي two types of micronumerosity. عندي the exact micronumerosity will near micronumerosity. The exact micronumerosity, the sample size is less than the number of the parameters. And therefore, عشان كده قلنا in this case, this is one of the OLS assumptions is violated, and that's why I cannot estimate the parameters. ولكن لو عندي near micronumerosity, okay, ودي اللي هتبقى في الquestion اللي بعد كده, بيبقى عندي the sample size اللي هي n is larger than the number of parameters, اللي هو number of betas. However, the n is still small enough to lead to lower variability in the axis, واللي بتخلي عندي large variances. Again, يبقى the exact micronumerosity arises when n, the sample size, is less than the number of parameters. And in this case, we cannot estimate the parameters. We cannot get a unique estimate of them. With this is similar to the problem of perfect multicollinearity. Number 10, a near micronumerosity, زي ما قلنا, arises when the number of observations barely exceeds the number of parameters to be estimated. يعني number of observations, اللي هي sample size بتاعتي, is larger than, يعني it barely exceeds, يعني it is larger than the number of parameters, but it is still very small that it will lead to having large variance. وبالتالي this statement is true. طيب, multicollinearity number 11. Multicollinearity is essential population phenomenon. It is false. The multicollinearity is essentially a sample phenomenon. Why? Because as we have agreed, and then I cannot get data on the population. And that's why I collect data on the sample and use it in order to estimate my parameters or my coefficients to know the shape of the relationship between the explanatory variables and the y. يبقى أنا زي ما قلنا في الأول إن أنا ما بيبقاش عندي data على the population, وعشان كده I take a sample of the population, بستخدم الداتا بتاعت السامبل دي عشان اعمل استيميشن للبارامترز او البيتا هاتس بتاعتي, واقدر اعمل بعد كده statistical inference اشوف هل البارامترز دي significant ولا لا, والاكسس دي بتاثر ازاي على الواي بتاعتي. So كل البروبلمز وكل الكلام بتاعي ان انا بتكلم على السامبل فينوم. يعني لو عندي problem of multicollinearity and I can change my sample or I can increase my sample, the multicollinearity problem will disappear. So multicollinearity is a sample phenomenon, not a population phenomenon. Question number 12. The large variability in a regressor. كل ما كان عندي larger variability in my explanatory variables, يعني بياخدوا قيم مختلفة بشكل كبير, the greater the precision with which its coefficient can be estimated. هل الcoefficient ده I can estimate it with high precision? Well, this is true. كل ما كان عندي larger variability in the values, ده معناها ان denominator بتاع variance beta 2 hat اللي هو summation small xi squared or summation xi minus x bar squared اللي هو الترم ده. كل ما كان عندي larger variability in the axis, كل ما الترم اللي تحت ده will be large وبالتالي variances will be small. يبقى عندي small variance or small standard error. طالما البارامتر بتاعي او الكوفيشنت بتاعي عنده small variance او small standard error, يبقى اقدر اقول ان it has been estimated with high precision او the greater the precision. يبقى معناها ايه؟ ان انا الكوفيشنت is estimated with a high precision او with a great precision. دي معناها ان انا الفارينس بتاعي او الفارينس بتاع البيتا هات is small. ايه اللي هيخليني هو يبقى small؟ لما يبقى عندي large variability in the regressor اللي بيخلي denominator بتاعي هي summation xi minus x bar all square تبقى small. اوكي تبقى سوري تبقى large, وده اللي هيخلي الفارينس بتاعي كله الايه, يبقى having large variability in the axis will lead to a larger value for summation xi minus x bar squared, يعني a larger value for the denominator of variance beta hat, وده هيخلي عندي small variance او standard error, وبالتالي اقدر اقول ان those estimates are estimated with high precision. Number 13. In the case of multicollinearity, the probability of failing to reject a false hypothesis type 2 error increases. It is true. One of the main implications of having imperfect multicollinearity is that type 2 error increases. Why does type 2 error increases? زي ما قلنا إننا the main implication of multicollinearity, imperfect multicollinearity, is that I have large variance. And large variances leads to having larger confidence intervals and lower T values. كل ما كان عندي wider confidence intervals with lower T values, لما ال T value بتاعتي تبقى قليلة, because in the standard error بتاع البيتا هات اللي هو في denominator increased, احنا قلنا ايه؟ انا عندي large variance. Large variance يعني عندي large standard error because of imperfect multicollinearity. ال T هي beta hat minus beta divided by the standard error of beta hat. وبالتالي لما يبقى عندي imperfect multicollinearity, the variance of beta hat will be large, the standard error of beta hat will be large, وبالتالي the denominator of the T will increase, leading to a decline in the value of the T. يبقى الT calculated بتاعتي هتقل بسبب ان انا حصل عندي increase in the variance or the standard error of beta hat. وبالتالي ده هيخليني اعمل ايه؟ طالما انها الT بتقل, ده هيخليني ان انا do not reject H node. يعني بدل مثلا ما المفروض انها كانت تطلع 2.4 عشان بقى عندي large variances الوقت, يعني 2.4 دي ان هي greater than 2, يعني it is reject H node, يعني this beta is significant. عندي problem of imperfect multicollinearity, خلت بدل ما T المفروض انها تبقى 2.4 بقت الوقت ان هي 1.5. يعني it is now multicollinearity has led to large variance or large standard error, واللي خلى عندي T value تقل بعد ما كانت 2.4, يعني كان البارامتر بتاعي significant وخلاني اعمل rejection لل H node, بقى 1.5 اللي هو less than 2, يبقى I do not reject H node. يبقى أنا قلت كأن إيه؟ البيتا هات دي is insignificant. So it increases, يبقى multicollinearity increases the probability of type 2 error, أو increases the type 2 error اللي هي probability of failing to reject a false hypothesis. بالرغم من ان المفروض ان هي تبقى 2.4, يعني I should reject H node, ان البيتا دي بتاعتي significant, لما حصلت ال problem of imperfect multicollinearity وخلت ال standard error بتاع البيتا هات يزيد وخلت ال T تقل وخلتني do not reject ال H node, يعني اعتبرت ان البيتا is insignificant, ده خلاني وقعني في type 2 error اللي هي the probability of failing to reject a null hypothesis is أو a false hypothesis. يعني the hypothesis اللي أنا I did not reject it ده كان the false hypothesis. المفروض إن أنا كنت أعمل له rejection. المفروض إن أنا كنت أعمل له rejection بس أنا ليه خدت القرار إن هو do not reject at null وقلت إن البيتا 2 أو البيتا هات بتاعتي is insignificant بسبب المالتي كولينياريتي. يبقى the probability of failing to reject the false hypothesis increases in the case of imperfect multicollinearity. Type number 14. In situation of extreme multicollinearity, dropping the highly collinear variable will often make the other X variables statistically significant. لو أنا عندي high degree of multicollinearity. Okay. لو أنا شلت الX اللي هي عاملة لي المشكلة بتاعت المالتي كولينياريتي دي then the other X variable will be statistically significant. This true. ليه؟ لأن أنا لو شلت الإكسبلاناتري variable أو الX اللي عاملة لي مشكلة المالتي كولينياريتي this will lead to a decline in the degree of collinearity. The multi collinearity will decline when I remove this X leading to small standard errors.